Welcome to Kishore Sneak Padasala. In this video, we will see the concept of atmospheric pressure and certain numericals. So atmospheric pressure is indicated by the letter P naught. Okay, suppose you assume a beaker in which there is water, then the pressure at surface is the atmospheric pressure P naught. Okay, and its value is P naught is equal to 1.013 into 10 power 5 Pascal, that is equal to 1 atm. That is equal to 76 centimeter of mercury. That is equal to 760 mm of mercury. That is equal to 760 torr. Okay, so pressure at surface is the atmospheric pressure P naught. Then let us see variation of pressure with depth. Suppose there is a hollow cylinder whose height is h, and inside the, if you dip inside the water also go inside, whose density is rho. Then pressure at surface is P naught. Let us assume the pressure at depth is P. Then P minus P naught, that is pressure at the depth minus atmospheric pressure, is rho gh, where P is equal to P naught plus rho gh. This formula is very, very important formula. You must remember. So pressure at depth is equal to pressure at depth, that is P, is equal to P naught plus rho into g into h, where h is the height from the surface of the water. Okay, h is height from surface. Okay, then P minus P naught is equal to rho g h, which is the gauge pressure. Gauge pressure is nothing but excess pressure at depth. Suppose they are asking calculate the excess pressure at depth, then you must calculate P minus P naught value, that is equal to rho gh, which is the gauge pressure. Now let us work out a numerical. What is the pressure on a swimmer 500 meter below the surface of the lake? So at depth, pressure is equal to P naught plus rho gh. So P naught is 1.013 into 10 power 5 Pascal plus density of water is 1000 kg per meter cube into acceleration due to gravity is 10 and height is 5 meter they have given. So 1.013 into 10 power 5 Pascal is plus 100 into 10 into 5. The answer comes out to be 1.513 into 10 power 5 Pascal. This is the pressure on a swimmer 5 meter below the surface. Now one special formula let us see, but this one for deriving we require integration and all, but that much time we don't get in exam. So just to remember, the average pressure of a liquid of density rho on the walls of the container filled up to a height h is 1 by 2 into rho gh. So average pressure of a liquid on the walls, if they ask, then it is 1 by 2 into rho g into h. Now let us see another one important note. Mercury barometer is the device, very important thing. It's a device used to find atmospheric pressure. We do not use water. See, we are using mercury barometer, not water. Why? Because see, this is the measurement, this is the thing, the beaker you are filling with water and you are dipping a tube, okay, this tube on the surface. So up to what height the mercury is rising, that is the atmospheric pressure. Suppose if it is rising 76 centimeter of mercury, then 76 centimeter of mercury is the atmospheric pressure. That is 1.013 into 10 power 5 Pascal. Okay, so mercury is rising up to 76 centimeters. So you can easily construct a tube, but you cannot use water, because here if you use water, then the water rise up to 10 meters. For 10 meter, you cannot build such a long tube. So we are using mercury barometer. Now let us see one numerical. If value of G, acceleration due to gravity at place, decreases by 3%, then change in height of mercury barometer. So if g decreases by 3%, then what is the, how does height decreases, they are asking. So p is how much, how does height varies, they are asking. P is equal to p naught plus rho gh. See here. Rho G H. So G is inversely proportional to H. You can easily find. So if G decreases by 3%, then height increases by 3%. So first A option is the right answer. See, P is equal to P naught plus rho G H. P minus P naught is equal to rho G H. Let us assume this to be a constant. Constant is equal to rho G H. So G is equal to constant by rho H. So G is inversely proportional to H. Okay, this only we are using here. Now this is the next numerical. If the pressure at half depth of a lake is 3 by 4 times the PA. So pressure at depth is equal to P naught plus rho GH. So pressure at half depth, simply depth you remember, and is 3 by 4 times the atmospheric pressure. So 3 by 4 times the atmospheric pressure is equal to P naught plus rho GH. Find the depth of the lake they are asking. So it is 1 by 4 P naught is equal to 1000 into G value is 10 into H we want to find. 1 by 4 into 1.013 into 10 power 5 Pascal is equal to 10,000 into H. So H is 10 meter. So this is the depth of the lake. Now this is a very very most important and a common type of numerical in a YouTube. There are two liquids here. For this side we are filling water whose density is 1000 up to 15 centimeter. On the other side we are filling oil up to 20 centimeter. What is the density of the oil they are asking? So P is equal to P naught plus rho G H. So P minus P naught is equal to rho G H. Let us assume this as a constant. So rho G H is a constant. So rho of, let us assume this as the first thing, this as the second thing. Rho of 1 into G of 1 into H of 1 is equal to rho of second fluid into acceleration due to gravity of second fluid into height of the second fluid. So acceleration due to gravity, everyone it is G only. So this and this one get G1, G2 get cancelled. So rho 1 into H1 is equal to rho 2 into H2. Rho 2 into H2. On the first side, we have water whose density is 1000 into H1 is 15 centimeter. 15 into 10 power minus 2 meter. Rho 2, oil we want to find. What is the density of oil? Oil is filled up to 20 centimeter. So 20 into 10 power minus 2. So 10 power minus 2, 10 power minus 2 get cancelled. 1000 into 3 by 4 is equal to rho of oil. So this and this is 250. So rho of oil is equal to 750 kg per meter cube. This is the density of oil and this is the most common type of numerical. Remember rho 1 H1 is equal to rho 2 H2. Suppose see that the same YouTube. Here one fluid they are filling up to height H1 of rho 1. Here up to this height H2 there is a fluid rho 2. And here there is a fluid rho 3, it is filled up to height h3. Then rho 1 h1 is equal to rho 2 h2 plus rho 3 h3. Okay, I hope you like this lecture. If you like this lecture, please subscribe Kishore's Neat Paathshala.